Excellences, distingués invités, mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour saluer le président par intérim de la...
Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. A very warm welcome to you all on behalf of Vatican Media, Vatican Radio, and all of my colleagues here at the Vatican Dicastery for Communication. I'm Devin Watkins, and it's my privilege to provide the commentary for this live broadcast of Pope Francis's meeting with the authorities, representatives of civil society, and the diplomatic corps of the Republic of Mauritius. On whatever platform, medium, or device you may be following this event, please know that we are so happy you could join us. We especially welcome our friends of Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Catholic TV, CBS News, and all of you joining us on local radio stations around the world. This broadcast is also available live right now on our Vatican Media audio app and Vatican News portal, which you can access at any time on vaticannews.va. Pope Francis is currently at the State House in Port Louis, in Mauritius, on his one-day apostolic journey to this island nation that lies in the Indian Ocean. Pope Francis is flanked by the president, the acting president, of Mauritius, on his left, standing on his right, on our left if you're joining us on TV. The president is Barlin Viapuri. And on the Pope's left, our right looking at him, is the Prime Minister, Pravind Kumar Jugnauth. Pope Francis's meeting with the authorities and diplomatic corps of Mauritius is the last event of this one-day apostolic journey to Mauritius. Earlier this morning, he arrived at around 9 o'clock local time and then celebrated Mass for the nation's faithful. After lunch, the Pope went to pray at the tomb of Blessed Father Laval, who is actually known as the Apostle of Mauritius, and it's today, coincidentally or not, is his feast day.
Distinguished invités, mesdames et messieurs, soyez les bienvenus à la State House en cette occasion si historique et si spéciale.
We can hear the local announcer there in the State House welcoming all of the dignitaries and Pope Francis to the event. She's speaking in French. French and English are the main languages of the island, even though it is a very multicultural and multi-ethnic island.
Merci, Madame. Très Saint-Père. Monsieur le Premier ministre.
This is the acting president, Barlin Viapuri. He's addressing the Pope. We'll give you a translation of his words. Most Holy Father, he says, dear Prime Minister, Your Eminence, Cardinal Maurice Piat, honorable ministers, honorable leader of the opposition, excellencies of the diplomatic corps, distinguished guests, good afternoon. You can imagine the emotion, joy, and pride I feel on this historic day, he says, to have the privilege of welcoming on behalf of the Mauritian nation, His Holiness Pope Francis, to the State House.
In 1989, ici même, le gouverneur général d'alors, Sir Virasamy Ringadou,
30 years ago in 1989, right here in this very place, my predecessor, President Outhim, received Pope John Paul II, whose visit to Mauritius left lasting memories in the minds of Mauritian citizens.
Pour l'honneur fait à la République de Maurice, petit pays dans l'océan Indien.
Thank you, Most Holy Father, for the honor shown to the Republic of Mauritius, a tiny country in the Indian Ocean that the Vatican kindly included during your visit. Your Holiness's visit is particularly significant because this September 9th coincides with the celebrations marking the 155th anniversary of the death of Blessed Father Laval, the Apostle of the Poor. Your visit to Father Laval's tomb will have an inestimable moral impact on the minds and hearts of Mauritians. What is truly remarkable is the fact that Father Laval has succeeded in consolidating national unity in our country, because his tomb nowadays is visited not only by Catholics, but also by Mauritians of other religious faiths. Most Holy Father, Mauritius's political and social development is both rich and diverse, with a population coming from different continents as a result of successive waves of immigration. Our young republic, which is home to all the major religious movements in the world, is working tirelessly to cultivate this coexistence that is essential to the construction of a harmonious nation. Thus, Mauritius has become not only a meeting place for civilizations, but also a place of spirituality where the Christian church harmoniously coexists with Hindu temples, and where a mosque of our Muslim compatriots peacefully borders the Buddhist pagoda. The spirit of sharing and respect for others that animates Mauritians has greatly contributed to this exemplary peaceful coexistence in Mauritius.
Avec grand intérêt, les efforts déployés par le Vatican au service de la paix.
Your Holiness, we follow with great interest, even at a distance of 10,000 kilometers from Rome, the Vatican's efforts in the service of world peace, as well as your constant calls for dialogue, human rights, the fight against extreme poverty, the education of all children, and recently, the ecology and rights of future generations to live on a habitable planet.
En donnant votre bénédiction à un nombre d'arbustes.
We are delighted, Your Holiness, that later on you will put your word into action by giving your blessing to a number of saplings arranged in the adjacent pavilion, which will then be planted throughout Mauritius, Rodriguez, and Agalega. This symbolic action will launch the commendable project Plant 100,000 Trees, an initiative of the non-governmental organization Society Project, in collaboration with the local Catholic diocese.
Pour saluer les actions du diocèse catholique sous la direction du cardinal Maurice Piat.
I would like to take this opportunity today to salute the actions of the Catholic Diocese under the leadership of Cardinal Maurice Piat for its commitment to national causes and for the outstanding work done in the field of education and social affairs.
Pour le soutien moral apporté à notre pays.
Most Holy Father, the Mauritian nation is also very grateful to Your Holiness for the moral support provided to our country, and particularly to the Chagossian people, in the long struggle that has been waged for several years for the return of the Chagos Archipelago, including Diego Garcia, to the Republic of Mauritius. The International Court of Justice and the United Nations have upheld Mauritius's just claim. The Chagossians, as well as compatriots from the islands of Agalega and Rodriguez Island, are out in great numbers for the various events marking Your Holiness's visit. We would also like to welcome our brothers and sisters from Réunion Island who have also come to welcome Your Holiness, whose visit is intended to be a truly Indian Ocean event. Most Holy Father, the special encounter that I and my family matters had with you just a moment ago has been of great value to us, and we will cherish it all our lives. Most Holy Father, on behalf of all Mauritians, I say to you very solemnly and respectfully, thank you for everything. We wish you excellent health and many more years in the service of peace and the well-being of humanity in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your attention.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. J'ai l'honneur d'inviter maintenant Monsieur le Premier ministre, Pravin Kumar Jagnauth, à
Those were the words of the acting president, Barlen Biapuri, and now the Prime Minister, Pravin Jagnauth, comes to the podium. Your Holiness, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, on this exceptional day, marked by the coming of His Holiness Pope Francis, all of us Mauritians feel a sense of joy and happiness. Our country once again receives the Vicar of Christ, 30 years after the historic visit of Pope John Paul II in Mauritius.
Votre venue chez nous a suscité un important élan populaire parmi nos compatriotes de toutes
Most Holy Father, Your coming to us has created substantial popular momentum among our compatriots of all faiths. They have discovered a man of conviction, knowledge, and dialogue, a man who exudes humility and simplicity, and a man very close to the people, close to their pain and to their concerns. Throughout your itinerary in our country, you have contributed to invigorating our spiritual dimension, and I would like to say a big thank you from the bottom of my heart. I am delighted to see that Mauritius is converging with the Vatican on major international issues such as world peace, climate change, and the fight against poverty.
Nous vous accueillons à Maurice comme pèlerin de la paix.
We welcome you to Mauritius as a pilgrim of peace. Today, the Mauritian people, as well as our brothers and sisters from the neighboring islands, accompanied by their bishops, were able to listen to your words of wisdom and reconciliation. Your apostolic journey to our island is an opportunity for believers of all faiths to experience an awakening of consciousness in our way of living together and therefore to dialogue together. Dialogue is at the heart of the Republic of Mauritius, a country made up of migrants from different cultures and religious backgrounds.
Nous reconnaissons la contribution importante du dialogue interreligieux.
Most Holy Father, we recognize the important contribution of interfaith dialogue, which is also an integral part of the Church's mission. The Council of Religions, which represents the major religions present in Mauritius, as well as the various Christian denominations, was founded in 2001 following an appeal by the United Nations for religious leaders to work together in each country to promote peace.
À Maurice, nous avons incontestablement dans notre ADN cette dimension.
Most Holy Father, in Mauritius, we undoubtedly have this multicultural dimension in our DNA. We have learned to gradually build a beautiful human mosaic in spite of, but above all, out of our differences. This little parcel of land at the heart of an ocean is daily a witness to the unique model of diversity and coexistence of communities. And we intend to continue in this beautiful multicultural adventure.
Nous savons que les disparités économiques
Your Holiness, we know that when economic, social, and cultural disparities are too great between peoples, the result is tension, discord, and endangered peace. I firmly believe that peace cannot be reduced to the absence of war. Peace is built day after day in the pursuit of perfect justice between human beings. Lasting peace for our rainbow country is essential. Mauritian society gives its full place to the human person and develops a broad solidarity effort in favor of the elderly and marginalized people with disabilities. Supporting and comforting the weakest is a moral imperative that transcends borders.
Votre sainteté, j'ai pris note de l'importance que vous accordez à l'éducation.
Your Holiness, I have taken note of the importance you attach to education. Our country is currently engaged in a process to align the Mauritian education system with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals of 2015 to 2030.
L'Église donne aussi un grand soutien dans le domaine de l'éducation à Maurice.
The Church has also given great support in Mauritius's field of education for more than 150 years. Your Holiness, in your speech to the Diplomatic Corps in the Vatican in January 2019, you said that it is normal for politicians to listen to the voices of their peoples and seek out concrete solutions for the greater good of all, but this requires respect for law and justice on both the national and international levels.
La communauté internationale, ici représentée, doit faire preuve de bonne volonté et de bonne
foi. The international community represented here must demonstrate goodwill and good faith, which are essential to the success of multilateral diplomacy. We thank you for your interest in the suffering of our citizens who were forcibly expelled from the Chagos archipelago by Great Britain after the illegal detachment of this part of our territory before our independence. As you know, following the request of the United Nations General Assembly, the International Court of Justice delivered an advisory opinion on 25th February, concluding inter alia that the Chagos Archipelago is an integral part of our territory and that Britain has an obligation to end its occupation of the archipelago as soon as possible.
De faciliter le retour de nos citoyens d'origine chagossienne dans
l'archipel. The Mauritian government has therefore declared its commitment to facilitate the return of our citizens of Chagossian origin to the Chagos archipelago and the repopulation of certain islands in order to restore the dignities of these same citizens. We hope to be able to count on the assistance of the international community to carry out this project. Your Holiness, I share your view that climate change is a global problem for the world's serious environmental, social, economic, and distributive impacts, as well as a political, and is one of the main challenges facing humanity today. We believe that international organizations will have to make a greater commitment to help middle-income countries such as Mauritius to develop resilient economies, given their vulnerabilities. Your Holiness, you are an ardent defender of the environment. You have brilliantly demonstrated that environmental degradation is driven by greed and spiritual impoverishment. The outer desert is created by the inner desert. At the United Nations General Assembly in September 2015, you encouraged the nations of the world to care for our common home. We know that you are not also not insensitive to the climate concerns of small island states.
Dans votre message au monde à l'occasion de la fête de Pâques cette année, Vous avez prié,
Your Holiness, in your message to the world on the occasion of Easter this year, you called on the risen Christ to put an end to the roar of weapons, both in conflict zones and in our cities. I would like to reiterate my support for this cause.
Votre visite coïncide avec le pèlerinage annuel vers la tombe du bienheureux Père Laval.
By a happy coincidence, your visit coincides with the annual pilgrimage to the tomb of Blessed Father Laval. Thanks to his remarkable missionary work, Father Laval has restored to the forgotten the dignity that belongs to each child of God. Your Holiness, your visit further strengthens the good relations between the Mauritian authorities with the Vatican. I hope that there will be more exchanges between our two states in the coming years. We pray to God to bless and protect us all, that the Almighty may guard and accompany you on your return to the Holy See and wherever else you may travel in the world. Thank you very much. That was the speech from the Prime Minister of Mauritius, Pravind Jugnauth.
Merci, Monsieur le Premier Ministre. Excellences, distingués invités, Mesdames et Messieurs, c'est avec beaucoup de bonheur et de respect que j'ai l'honneur et l'immense plaisir.
And now we have the presenter announcing Pope Francis for his speech to the authorities, representatives of civil society, and diplomatic corps of Mauritius. And the Holy Father makes his way to the podium. Mr. President, Mr. Prime Minister, said Pope Francis. Honorable members of government and the diplomatic corps, distinguished representatives of civil society and the different religious confessions, ladies and gentlemen, I offer a cordial greeting to the authorities of the state of Mauritius, and I thank them for the invitation to visit your republic. I thank the Prime Minister for his kind words and for the reception that he and the President accorded me. I greet the members of government, the representatives of civil society and the diplomatic corps. I would also acknowledge the presence among us of representatives of other Christian confessions and of the different religions present in Mauritius, and I thank them fraternally. Thanks to this brief visit, I have the pleasure of encountering your people, not only for cultural, ethnic, and religious diversity, which it is known, but above all for the beauty born of the ability to acknowledge, respect, and harmonize existing differences in view of a common project. This sums up the history of your people, born of the arrival of migrants from different horizons and continents who brought their own traditions, cultures, and religions, and gradually learned to be enriched by the differences of others, and to find ways of living together and striving to build a society committed to the common good. In this regard, you possess an authoritative voice, one that has taken on life, a voice that can remind us that it is possible to achieve lasting peace when we start with the conviction that diversity is a beautiful thing, when it can constantly enter into a process of reconciliation and seal a sort of cultural covenant resulting in a reconciled diversity. This in turn serves as a foundation for the opportunity to build true fellowship within the greater human family, without feeling the need to marginalize, exclude, or reject anyone.
Di quei movimenti migratori che hanno portato i vostri antenati su questa isola e che li hanno anche.
Your people's DNA preserves the memory of the move of those movements of migration that brought your ancestors to this island and led them to be open to differences, to integrate them, and to promote them for the benefit of all. For this reason, I encourage you, in fidelity to your roots, to take up the challenge of welcoming and protecting those migrants who today come looking for work and, for many of them, better conditions of life for their families. Make an effort to welcome them, following the example of your ancestors who welcomed one another. Be protagonists and defenders of a true culture of encounter that enables migrants and everyone to be respected in their dignity and their rights. Recalling the recent history of your people, I would like to render homage to the democratic tradition that took root following your independence and that helps to make Mauritius a haven of peace. I express the hope that this art of living democracy can be cultivated and developed, especially by resisting every form of discrimination. For authentic political life, grounded in law and in frank and fair relations between individuals, experiences renewal whenever we are convinced that every woman, man, and generation brings the promise of new relational, intellectual, cultural, and spiritual energies. May those of you engaged in the political life of the Republic of Mauritius be examples to the men and women who count on you, in particular to the young. By your conduct and your determination to combat all forms of corruption, may you demonstrate the grandeur of your commitment in service to the common good, and always be worthy of the trust placed in you by your fellow citizens. Since its independence, your country has experienced a steady economic development that should certainly be a reason to rejoice, but also to be on guard. In the present context, it appears that economic growth does not always profit everyone and even sets aside, by certain of its mechanisms and processes, a certain number of people, particularly the young. That is why I would like to encourage you to promote an economic policy focused on people and in a position to favor a better division of income, the creation of jobs, and the integral promotion of the poor.
A non cedere alla tentazione di un modello economico idolatrico che ha bisogno di sacrificare vite umane.
To encourage you not to yield to the temptation of an idolatrous economic model that feels the need to sacrifice human lives on the altar of speculation and profit alone, considering only immediate advantage to the detriment of protecting the poor, the environment, and its resources. This entails moving forward with that constructive approach that, as Cardinal Piat wrote on the 50th anniversary of Mauritius's independence, works for an integral ecological conversion. A conversion that seeks not only to avoid terrible climatic phenomena or extreme natural catastrophes, but also to promote a change in the way we live, so that economic growth can really benefit everyone, without the risk of causing ecological catastrophes or serious social crises.
Desidero esprimere apprezzamento.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to express my appreciation for the way that here in Mauritius the different religions, while respecting their specific identities, work hand in hand to contribute to social harmony and to uphold the transcendent value of life against every kind of reductionism. And I express once more the desire of the Catholics of Mauritius to continue to participate in this fruitful dialogue that has so deeply marked the history of your people. Thank you for your witness. Once again, I thank all of you for your warm welcome. I ask God to bless your people and every effort you make to foster the encounter of different cultures, civilizations, and religious traditions in the promotion of a just society, one that does not forget its young, and above all, those who are most vulnerable. May God's love and mercy continue to accompany you and to protect you. Thank you so much for your attention. And Pope Francis concludes his speech to the authorities, representatives of civil society, and diplomatic corps of Mauritius. And he has met and shakes hands with the Prime Minister.
Très Saint-Père, nous vous remercions vraiment du fond du cœur pour votre message puissant et inspirant que nous porterons dans notre cœur pour toujours. C'est aussi avec joie et gratitude que nous recevons votre bénédiction aujourd'hui et nous en sommes profondément touchés et reconnaissants. Excellences, Mesdames et Messieurs, notre cérémonie officielle arrive presque à sa fin. En effet, sous peu,
she's announcing that the current event has reached its end. And Pope Francis, in his speech to the diplomatic corps and politicians and civil servants of Mauritius, called for a better distribution of economic prosperity, which the island has quite a bit of, to all sectors of society. The Pope especially mentioned young people in his words, just as a way of a few data. Youth unemployment in Mauritius hovered around 23% in 2018, which would be for 15 to 24-year-olds, and while the overall unemployment was around 7%. The Pope pointed out this disparity in his speech to the civil servants of Mauritius, and at the same time he praised the country's steady economic development, which has happened since its independence in 1968. The Pope said that it appears that economic growth does not always profit everyone. He said it even sets aside, by certain of its mechanisms and processes, a certain number of people, particularly the young. And so Pope Francis urged Mauritius's political leaders to promote an economic policy focused on people. One, he said, that favors a better division of income, the creation of jobs, and integral promotion of the poor. The alternative, the Holy Father noted, would be to yield to the temptation of an idolatrous economic model that feels the need to sacrifice human lives on the altar of speculation and profit alone. If you're following us on TV, you can see that Pope Francis has made his way to the pavilion outside the State House, or in a certain point of it, and he is preparing to bless saplings, as the President mentioned, or the Prime Minister mentioned. These saplings will be distributed throughout Mauritius and the other islands, and as part of an initiative, an ecological initiative to reforest these islands. Let's go back just a minute to the Pope's words and speech to the civil society of Mauritius. In his words, the Pope also praised the democratic tradition that makes Mauritius, quote what he said, a haven of peace. Beautiful phrase. And he encouraged politicians to be examples to their compatriots in their conduct and fight against corruption. He said that the island nation's culture is a result of successive waves of migration, as both the president and the prime minister pointed out, and which makes it particularly diverse. Around 48% of the country's population of 1.26 million is Hindu. 33% of the island nation's population is Christian, 26% of which is Catholic, the largest portion of Christians, and around 17% Muslim. Buddhism is also present at under 1% of the population. And given this multi-ethnic, multi-religious, and multicultural reality, Pope Francis called on Mauritians to be protagonists and defenders of a true culture of encounter that enables migrants and everyone to be respected in their dignity and their rights. He particularly mentioned migrants because, as the Prime Minister pointed out, the nation is made up of successive waves of migration, mostly from colonial times. It was first colonized by the French, who then handed it on to the United Kingdom, and it won its independence. And finally, in Pope Francis's speech, he voiced his appreciation for the way that the nation's different religions work together towards building a harmonious society. And he said he involved the Catholic community of Mauritius, which makes up 26%, to continue its, and he pledged that the Catholic Church would continue to participate in a fruitful dialogue that has so deeply marked the history of the Mauritian people. Pope Francis, after shaking hands with many of the dignitaries, has made his way outside the State House in Port Louis. He's preparing to get in to the papal car. With this, the Pope will depart and prepare for his departure. His next stop is at the airport. This is his last public event. So he's going to the airport. From there, he will fly back to Madagascar, Antananarivo, where he will stay the night. And then tomorrow morning, Tuesday morning, he will leave bright and early and then come back to Rome. And with that, we conclude this live broadcast of Pope Francis's meeting with the authorities, representatives of civil society, and diplomatic corps of the Republic of Mauritius. Do remember that this event is available on our Vatican YouTube channel and our Vatican News portal, where you will find summaries of the Holy Father's discourses and homilies, as well as reports on his main activities. You can find us at www.vaticannews.va. Thanks again to all of you who've joined us on our local radio stations around the world or on Catholic Faith Network, so Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Catholic TV, and CBS News. Until next time, on behalf of Vatican Media, I'm Devin Watkins, wishing you every blessing. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ.